Alrighty, my favorite diecast of his, here is Ryan Blaney's 2020 Jack Lynx Menards Ford Mustang. Howdy, howdy, folks. It's Diecast Buffet here again, back with another NASCAR diecast review. And today's car is going to be Ryan Blaney's 2020 Jack Lynx Menard Ford Mustang. And yes, this is the first NASCAR diecast we'll be reviewing with the brand new windshield banner. That's not only the banner, there's also some window bars. The decals have been printed on. So this is something new that Lineout Racing is doing for 2020, which it has been years. I mean, years since we've had a front windshield banner. Of course, whenever they switched it over from the driver name being on the front windshield to the back, you know, Monster Energy, you know, all that crap. They don't want energy drinks being on the diecasts, you know, of course, you know, without a base or whatnot. But anyways, they finally brought it back. And for those who don't know about the window bars there, they used to have those on 164 non-elite diecast. Now, I can't recall one being made on the Action / Winter Circle mold, but I will tell you, though, I think it was Team Caliber, maybe Revell as well, but I know Hot Wheels used to do that, so that's quite interesting to see how that returned to the NASCAR diecast world. But this is a Ryan Blaney diecast that is just bright, beautiful day glow with the red, and I tell you what, man, Jack Lynx Ford Mustang, that is just so freaking cool. So you got Team Penske on the front. Of course, you got your silver ribbon around the box, and I'm just excited for all these new diecasts we'll be reviewing. I mean, if you love the new releases, I mean, go ahead and hit that subscribe button down below, man. Every day, 5 p.m. Eastern Standard Time for like the next week or so, we're going to have all new Gold Series releases. And wow, that I don't know why, but that just looks so different, seeing the Cup Series logo and the NASCAR race car logo with that banner. Anyways, guys, let's go ahead and take a closer look at the new banner and get this 2020 Jack Lynx Menards Ryan Blaney Ford Mustang out of the box. Alrighty, folks, brand new out of the package. Here it is, folks. Menards Jack Lynx Ford Mustang for Ryan Blaney. And first and foremost, look at the wheels. I mean, just something looks a little bit different. Like, this one barely looks like there's any paint there. I mean, that one looks very PTC-esque. The right rear, though, or left rear, excuse me, doesn't look that bad. But anyways, red, you got the day glow, you got the black splitter. I mean, you got the yellow day glow wheels. I mean, there's a lot going on with this race car. And I tell you what, man, it looks fantastic. I mean, I really thought this car was going to get DMP'd, and I heard some rumors, and they were saying, no, this car is actually going to get made. It's going to get released in the Gold Series. I was just tickled pink about it, man. I was like, when and where can I pre-order? Because this is a fantastic looking paint scheme, and to my knowledge, this is the first Jack Lynx car that was ever made. But I tell you what, man, that is just so freaking cool. Over here to the nose of the diecast, you got Jack Lynx protein snacks. I mean, you know what? Everyone has their own favorite kind of beef jerky, right? Some people like the hickory. Some people like the spicy. Some people like the original teriyaki. Which one of the Jack Lynx beef jerky flavors is your favorite? I personally pretty much love them all, except for like the sweet and hot. I never really liked that one. I love the jalapeno kind. That is some good stuff. I wish they made it in the big bags where I live, but that stuff's good, but it's way too expensive. So you got pencil over here on the nose, and wow, not bad so far for the decal wrap. This headlight's a little bit lower, but I mean, compared to the Lino usual standards, that's actually a very sharp looking front end. Of course, you got the blue oval, got the Mustang font there, got the little pony running there, got the white number 12, no Team Penske logo there, Lincoln Welders, Sunoco, and a black splitter. You can see a little bit of that day glow line kind of just seeping above that, but nonetheless, what a fantastic looking race car. And then over here to the left side of this car, sure, this thing's looking like a non-ripe banana, but that's just day glow for you, folks. You got Ryan Blaney above the driver's side window. You got Ford, whatever that is, PPG, Mazak, Discount Tire, Advanced Auto Parts. That's going to be a diecast that's going to be coming up I think in June. I think that's actually going to be released in June, so that's going to be interesting. Dex Imaging, Menards, Knopf, Richmond Water Heaters, Jack Lynx, American Ethanol. Got the Penske number 12. Is that a white outline or like a very light gray? I'm not too sure. On camera, it looks like a light gray, but, you know, off camera, it's like so close to white. Who knows? I got a big screw up here with the NASCAR race car logo, and you got the NASCAR Cup Series logo. Got Goodyear there. I mean, just wow, man, that is freaking awesome. I love how it's just like a simple template-based paint scheme where you could put any sponsor, any color on this car, and it would look good, right? You could put red, you could put blue, you could put green, you could put white. I mean, you could put whatever you want. And if I remember correctly, they're going to be making a Matt DiBenedetto Menards diecast down the road. So if that's the case, that's fantastic. I don't remember what the hood sponsor was, but I remember looking at the shipment reports. I mean, heck, they've already announced that a Kurt Busch 164 is getting made in the Gold Series, the gear wrench car. So if you want to get that car, go ahead and pre-order, because guess what? It's going to get made. I checked the shipment reports recently, and it said it's going to be shipped out. It might be June or might be July. I'm not sure, but it is going to be made. That's going to be exciting. And then over here to the caboose of this diecast, you got Menards. I mean, the whole decal here, I mean, it's all just flapped over. Like, this is pressed on, and then this whole thing just kind of shifted up, and then they try to flatten it out. So that's unfortunate. I got the number 12 there. I got the Made in Michigan Ford license plate. You got Money Line as well. But that just, that red, the black of the day glow. I don't know why. It's such a, you know, a very unique three set of colors. But man, does it look freaking good. And then over here to the right side of this diecast, once again, guys, you got that beautiful day glow. The wheels, I mean, on camera, they don't look like a close match, but I tell you what, though, off camera, it's about as close as you're going to get, so they didn't really screw up on that, but I mean, it's day glow. At least they didn't make it freaking green banana, but I mean, on camera, I mean, you could try to, you know, toy with the day glow, but I mean, it's just, it's day glow. You can't do much about it. Like, I could drop the, you know, the brightness, and it looks like that. I can increase the brightness, you know. It's just day glow. It's design. It's a special paint they use that's supposed to show up extremely bright, not only to the naked eye, but also to your film equipment. That's just how it looks at the racetrack. It's just part of it. Ask Robbie Noonan about that, Mr. Race Day 2011. He could probably tell you an hour about it and how it does this and why it's so important that they do it. So I think this is awesome, guys. I mean, look at this. Ford got the Cup Series. I mean, finally we got Cup Series banners. Now, look, I'm not a fan of the banners on stock cars. That's just not me, okay? But I, for the sake of authenticity and the realism that is present here, I'm okay with it. You know, I'm not going to go, you know, write home about it. I'm not going to be all grumpy about it. But I tell you what, though. For what it is, it actually looks really good on the car. Personally, I could do without banners in general. That's just me. But I do like the window bars. I think that's a very nice touch. And, you know, people will be able to use these for their customs. Will we ever get back window ones? I doubt it. But hey, man, I mean, it's a start. I'm surprised Lionel actually went the extra step to put that detail on the car, knowing it's going to take them probably like not even a penny's worth of ink to be able to print that. I got the number 12 there, just chilling on the roof, very nice. And you got Ryan Blaney on the rear name banner, and go over here to the deck lid, and oh boy, you got all kinds of good stuff. You got Maytag, Kid, Libman, Jack Lynx, Atlas, Moen, Cardell, Sylvania, Duracell, and Tarquette. Alrighty, folks, that is it for today's NASCAR diecast review. Holy cow, man. This was the car I wanted so badly out of this freaking, this diecast haul recently. I tell you what, though. You got the day glow, you got the red. I mean, this thing is popping, baby. This thing is a beautiful paint scheme. Easily my favorite Ryan Blaney diecast. You know, I'm a huge beef jerky guy. And to see them make a diecast of it, holy cow. That is fantastic. Absolutely 100% recommend. I mean, if you're a Blaney cat, you're going to need this diecast. But I tell you what, man. You know, if you just like collecting good paint schemes, this is a good paint scheme to pick up. Absolutely recommend. Anyways, guys, thank y'all so much for watching the video. Make sure to give it a big thumbs up, like, comment, and subscribe. Of course, go ahead and check me out on Instagram at DiecastBuffet. Over 4,000 followers over there. Go ahead and check me out over there. All the behind-the-scenes stuff I do on a daily basis, you know, custom diecasts, you know, teasers on new videos and all that good stuff. Anyways, folks, hope you're having a great one. Diecast Buffet, signing off.